I'm so excited. Do you guys know Naeemah LaFond? Do you know her braids from Amika? She literally changed like her whole life. She was supposed to be somewhere else, and she made it happen so she could be here on our stage because we are so excited. We love her work. We love her energy, her personality, and of course we love her hair. If you haven't seen it, well, I'm sure you have, but I get lost behind it. It's big. She has, and like I said, her work, her braiding work, you've got to follow all these guys. Her braiding work is incredible. We love Amika and thank them so much for being with us today. So ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Naeemah LaFond from Amika.
Introducing Amika Armory, a collection of high-performance tools expertly designed to withstand even the toughest conditions for use by true hair experts who need equipment they can count on. Meet the antidote, a true remedy, the go-to tool for hot tool addicts. Nano-silk technology mends the appearance of dry and damaged hair by harnessing heat for healthier looking hair. Plates are coated with a unique fusion of silk, Teflon, and ceramic. The immortal will never die on you. The search for the ultimate dryer has finally ended. The immortal keeps going for 10,000 hours. Its brushless motor will keep going long after other blow dryers have quit, while being lightweight and whisper quiet. The accomplice, your partner in crime, every day and on the go. The accomplice is up to 70% faster than a conventional dryer while being a lightweight, compact powerhouse. Introducing the confidant. Trust her with your deepest hair secrets. She will keep them all. iRed Beam technology locks in moisture, so hydration levels are not only maintained, but replenished. The embedded ion projector keeps hair frizz-free and shiny. Amika Armory, because every woman needs her weapons.
Welcome to the stage, Amika's Global Artistic Director, Naeemah LaFond.
Hi guys, how are you? I am so thrilled, so excited to be here and share this moment with you guys. Working with Behind the Chair has been a dream for me, okay? A lot of people ask me, how did I get to this point in my career? For me, you know, people measure success in different ways. For me, this is, I'm not a millionaire by any means, but for me, today is a moment of success for me because I get to be on stage and share something that I'm passionate about and share my love for your hairdressing with you guys, so thank you. So Mary was up on stage earlier telling her story, giving me all the feels, and I'm like, I can't start crying right now, but I love to hear people's stories, and I just want to tell you a little bit about my story and how I got here today before we get into some hair, okay? Is that cool? All right. So I want to let you guys know that you have to fight for who you want to be in this world. You have to fight who you want to be in life, okay? So I didn't wake up and all of a sudden I'm on stage in front of all of you guys and doing hair and traveling the world. I would say 8 years ago is when I started doing education, and I taught my first class, which had about like 20 people in it, and I literally wanted to like crawl into a hole and die because I was like so nervous about speaking in front of people and just sharing what I know. And I took a moment and I'm like, wait, I need to like reevaluate this. Is this something that I'm supposed to be doing? It was always a goal of mine, seeing like all these like celebrity hairdressers on stage and traveling the world. I'm like, I want to do that, but this fear is like blocking me. So I said to myself, I need to work on that. I need to figure out how I'm gonna get to that next level. So I was like watching like self-help videos on YouTube, reading books, getting up on that stage and just, you know, making sure that I push through that fear. And also knowing that, you know, instead of me standing up on stage or getting in front of a class and picturing everyone naked, the better route would just to be believing in myself. So I want you guys to believe in yourselves. That's where it starts, okay? So, as I said, I was super scared and, you know, fast forward to where I am today, there were a lot of hurdles and roadblocks and, you know, people that are not going to believe in you and opportunities that are completely missed. Just know that for what's yours is going to be yours no matter what. You don't have to, you know, be cutthroat and step on anyone's neck. What's for you in life, the universe is going to hand to you and it's going to be there for you. All you have to do is show up, okay? So, you guys ready to get into some hair? All right, let's get started. So you guys saw the Armory video. That's Amika's new tool collection. And I want to share with you some really cool tips and tricks. You guys like some big hair? As you can tell, I'm a little bit into big hair myself. So I want to share with you some techniques, all right? So we're going to show you today how to use the Bombshell Blowout Interchangeable Brush, okay? So I love this because you sometimes want to create that blow-dry look, but you don't have time to literally go from wet to dry, right? A client is like, you know, I want to come in, I want to get a blowout. I literally only have about 15 minutes. Like, what can you do for me? You can't wash them and go from wet to dry in 15 minutes. And curling it with a curling iron is not going to give you the same kind of look. You have to know that a blow-dry look and the curling iron look are two different things. A blowout look with a round brush is going to give you a fluffier finish than if you were to use a curling iron, okay? So I'm using our interchangeable brush here. I'm just placing the brush right behind this section of hair, and I'm going to just treat it as if it were just a regular round brush if I were using the blow dryer. The only thing you're missing is the blow dryer, okay? So you're literally tucking the hair into the brush and rolling in. I'm gonna go roll all the way in to her base, hold for a few seconds, and then roll out. Okay? So how's that look? Really good? So what we're gonna do is gonna go ahead and brush her out. I'm gonna take my detangling brush. I'm gonna spin her around so you can see the brush out. So we prepped all of this for you, as you can see, so that we're not on stage curling for a million years. But we've prepped her for you. And I'm just brushing her out. When you initially start to brush out a blowout, you want to use a detangling brush so you can get through all of those curls, okay? You don't want to use a grooming brush. Difference between the grooming and the detangling brush has like wider spacing in it. Okay? Brushing through. See, we're getting that beautiful, kind of like sexy hair happening. See how it's like breaking through those curls for me? I'm gonna come on her other side here, do the same thing, brush away. Pass me that Amika Headstrong hairspray, please, Marissa. Thank you. And I'm going to have her tilt her head back a touch. And we're going to go in, and we're going to spray from the bottom. When you're creating volume, you always want to spray from the bottom. Think of gravity. I'm not going to start spraying on top first. You want to work from the bottom up with your spraying, and then turn around for me all the way. Then let's finesse the front. So for that, we're gonna use our grooming brush, right? And our Headstrong hairspray. finessing her. And then I'm going to use this Headstrong hairspray. The reason why I want to use Headstrong is because it's going to give a nice freeze hold to the hair. And that interchangeable round brush gives that beautiful bounce of a blowout. Okay? We're going to come on the other side and do the same thing. Thank you. Again, we're finessing her hair. All we did was use the interchangeable round brush to set her hair in curls. This is not a curling iron. This is not a blowout. This is using the Amika interchangeable bombshell blowout brush. Spray her. What do you guys think? Sexy big hair? All right, so we're going to move on to our next model here. And this one is all about, like, big, amazing texture, okay? And I'm going to take this section and clip out. So I did a braid on the top here. Let me tilt her head down to show you. This is the figure eight braid. And if you guys follow me on Instagram, but I do a lot of braids. I'm not doing this braid for you today, since today is all about like texture and big hair. But we do have a webinar with Behind the Chair on May 15th. You guys should sign up for that. It's going to be super cool and amazing, okay? So we're going to start with doing the figure eight technique for this texture on our model here. So what I did is I took a section of hair, a little bit of hairspray, and then I'm taking my long hairpin, all right? I'm going to open it a bit, put the hair into the hairpin, and then I'm going to hold with my finger. And then you want to figure eight the hair around the hairpin. And as you can see, every time I wrap it around, I use my thumb to push the hair back, okay? Just to make sure that all of the hair is gonna fit onto this hairpin. See how her hair is like really long, she has hair extensions in, but as long as you're pushing that back with your thumb, you can totally fit the full strand onto this, okay? Pushing it in. All right, now we're at the end. I'm gonna be using the Amika Antidote Styler, the one with the silk wrap technology. And I'm going to press this heat into the hair. The reason why I'm okay with such an extreme technique with like pressing heat into the hair like this is because that I know I'm using this kind of tool. Your tools are gonna determine whether or not you protect the integrity of your client's hair or whether her hair is gonna like start falling out tomorrow, okay? Just pull the hairpin out, and then we have this beautiful texture. I'm gonna go in, and I'm going to start to brush through all of this, but you have to do it strategically so that you get the most volume, okay? I'm like just taking my hand and tucking the top layer to the side, because I don't wanna just put all of her hair down and start going to town on it. I wanna make sure that I get all of the layers. Gonna turn your head for me, perfect. All of the layers, starting from the bottom, and we're just brushing out. Again, you don't want to lay it all down. You wanna make sure you brush out in layers. And there's this layer. This is a very like editorial look, something that you would do for like a photo shoot or a fashion show. So it's a great technique to have in your arsenal, all right? Come around her. Now we're gonna come around on this side as well. Again, tucking the top layer away and starting to brush the bottom. And you can see that this technique gives a lot of texture and it gives a lot of volume. Let's say you're not necessarily looking to do something like this, but you're trying to give your client some volume and some lift. You can do this figure eight technique just at the root of her hair and just do like regular curls at the rest. And what it's gonna do is just gonna lift her hair for you, and no one's gonna see that you have this texture at the root. It's just gonna give you some nice, let's say instead of using a texture iron, using the figure eight hairpin technique, okay? Going through and brushing. So I want to use a little bit of my Amika Undone Texture Spray as well, just to add a little bit more texture to this. And maybe some of our Headstrong Hairspray. So how I'm using the Headstrong Hairspray, I'm lifting the hair up and I'm going in. I want to keep it nice and airy, okay? Lifting, going in. Lifting, going in. Do you see how much volume we've created in just a few minutes? Nice and big. I'm going to come around to her front, take a look at her here. Looking good. All right, so what do you guys think of this big texture look? Cool. All right, so we're gonna move on to our next look in the middle here. All right. So, 1 second, hold off on the gift just for a second. So, before we start doing that, I wanna tell you that we're gonna start with just flat ironing the side of her hair. And I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna do a 5 minute updo for you guys. You think I can do something in 5 minutes? Okay, so right now I'm using our amazing Confidant Styler to just straighten the side of her hair before we start on our 5 minute updo. Sealing in all that moisture. And then let's throw that time clock up.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hairspray. minute 30 left. A minute 30. Concentration. Go, Naeemah. Let's clap, you guys. Go. Boom.
Challenge over.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. Guys, love you. Make sure you head over to the Amika booth and check out our tools. See you soon.
Great job.